It's almost making me not want to do this. Pissed me off. New profile, the old one I forgot.
So surreal.
Famously called film Little Pieces of Time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay. I'm in class. Everything's cool. I am okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black
and white? I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller.
Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel...
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
It's not that bad.
Like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as tortured, right? And frankly, it's bullshit.
If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
Holy shit, 8 pages.
Shit. Shh, 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 shh. Keep that to yourself. Seriously, though, I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation.
What?
And any one of you could do that to me. Isn't that too easy? Too obvious? What if Arbus chose to capture people?
My little camera bag is battered, but still kicking.
She had a brilliant eye. So, she could have taken another approach.
I have to admit.
I can't believe I still have this pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century.
I should take a picture to prove I'm still here.
Me too, Victoria.
Plus, it's perfect for my portfolio. And I have to get my daily selfie quota.
And there was honesty about the economic conditions of the era. But a beauty in the struggle. You don't have beauty without a beat. Which explains why Frank was Kerouac's photographic muse. And both were the great chroniclers of the 1950s. Well, we've all seen that iconic shot of Kerouac on the balcony. And if you haven't, shame, shame. Capturing the romantic urban solitude of the 20th century poet. You dig? Now, contrast Frank's stark Americana with Salvador Dali's surrealist photographs. Like Cocteau, he was a true Renaissance man. And his famous self-portraits are famous...
I do love my analog camera. I should take a quick picture now.
The selfie. And it's a great tradition, and I wholeheartedly fight for your right to... Shh, shh, shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry. I couldn't photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
You're asking me? Let me think.
You either know this or not, Max.
Whoa.
Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria. The Daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s onward. The first American daguerreotype self-portrait was done by Robert Cornelius. You can find out all about him in your textbook, or even online. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me. Yes, Victoria, you still have to do your homework this week. Even if you're submitting your photo for the competition, everybody in class is turning in a photo, so you see the dilemma?
There's always that one class, though.
I just worked so hard on the shot, and I'm sure you know what it's like to be consumed by your work.
Now I wish I wouldn't have read this. Purge.
I just really think Everyday Heroes is an important cultural event. And I want to represent...
Looks like somebody was already working on this. Cool.
It's all right.
You have just by participating. By putting
yourself out there
in the world. Hi, Max.
Jesus Christ, you haven't looked... You look like you haven't slept in like 3 weeks.
I also want everybody to know that this photographic...
Kate, I hope I didn't embarrass you with my lame answer.
It sucks to be dragged into the spotlight.
Unless you're Victoria.
She's got nothing on you, Max. Well, I should get going.
Yeah, me too. Talk to you later.
Sure. Let's talk later, Max.
Don't you guys talk about a coffee or something? I already stuffed up what
Let's
I wanted.
Let's talk later, Max.
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria, excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Do I have to? I just don't think it's that big a deal.
Max. You're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch-up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. And that's what separates the artist from the amateur.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
Welcome to the real world.
Hot.
Then I might send you a special picture.
Because Max wants everybody to see how cute she is.
I'm not paying her.
She plays it so sharp.
I need a serious time out in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that class. It's so fucking boring.
So what I always do. Sit down, plug the earphones in, make sure everyone knows that you don't give a shit about it.
To all of you American girls, it's sad to Imagine a world without you. American girls, I'd like to be part of the world around you.
Empty. Good. Nobody can see my meltdown. Except for me.
Yeah, you died from a long shot.
I feel like the universe is taunting me everywhere I go today. It all started with that bizarro dream in class. Am I going crazy?
Yes, you really are. What now? Oh, for God's sake. That's just... not necessary. That's the part where... Oh, no, I still gotta take the butterfly picture.
Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Fuck it.
Fuck your gift. Yep, knew it. Fuck your gift. I did that one. Kind of.
When a door closes, a window opens. Or something
butterfly
like that.
Effect.
Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day.
Done. Take my fist.
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that?
Who the fuck I
what
am?
Are you doing?
Oh, who am I? Oh,
come on, put that thing down!
Oh yeah,
ever.
Definitely with
tell
the gunshot angle like
so
that. That's definitely gonna kill
trying
somebody.
To control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Trouble. Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Boom! No. So like that long shot. That's a definite. Oh yeah, that's definite murder. That's just. Yeah, there's no leaving that one. You gone, bitch. You done.
Whoa.
There's no coming back from
what
that
the fuck?
One.
How can that be? I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand. And then I was back here.
As he likely was. These pieces of time can frame us.
I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color.
Now Kate is being hassled again. And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now,
shit!
Can you give me an example of a photographer?
I cannot believe this.
Captured the human condition in black and white.
Okay, if I'm crazy, I might as well go all the way.
Bueller?
Diane.
Can I actually reverse time?
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel like totally haunted by the.
Alright, let's rewind. There we go. I'm just like, there was a way to go.
I did it.
Can you
I actually did it.
A photographer who perfectly
I'm
captured
a human,
the human
time
condition
machine.
In black and white. Anybody?
Bueller? Max, don't freak out. Not yet.
There you go, Victoria. Why are
when I took my selfie, Jefferson asked me a question. If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
Kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
I know I'm not dreaming
course,
this.
You all know, the
it's real.
Portrait has been popular
I can tell.
Since the early 1800s. Your generation
so I can
the
go back in time.
For selfie expression.
What if that girl isn't dead yet?
I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for...
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
The Daguerrean process. I have to use the bathroom.
I'm sorry, but I really have to use the bathroom.
Nice try, Max. But you're not going to get away that easy. We can talk more after class. Is there anybody here
shit.
Who knows their stuff?
Jefferson wants to keep me after class. And I need time to save that girl.
A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria. Definitely.
What if I rewind again and give him the right answer?
More detail in people's faces, making them extremely... Max.
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of Evan. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Max, you are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Okay. Could do that?
She'll have better equipment than Blackwell.
What the fuck? Even if you're submitting your photo for the competition, let's go talk to Kate.
Nice answer, Max. Are you okay? You look pale.
Kate, did we talk at all today?
This is the first time. What's wrong?
I'm sorry, I'm just dripping. Too much stress.
Dripping balls.
I know the feeling.
I wish I didn't. I wish we didn't. I wish we didn't. I wish we didn't watch.
I wish we didn't. I do have to go, but we can talk later if you want.
I'll see how I feel. Thanks, Max.
Again. What happened to getting
coffee? I had my moment in the camera eye, and everybody...
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria, excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid...
I'm not avoiding, just...
Biding time? Waiting for the elusive right moment?
Exactly.
Max, don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Go on now. Don't let me stop you.
Yeah, that's it. You do push L1 to get out of it.
Everybody should have
totally.
That chance.
Excuse... I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers. Good. Make sure you finish working on it by today.
That is literally what I would
do. I have
do.
Faith in you.
Seriously. If I had time travel powers, I'd just go back in time, get all that right, get all the right answers. Make everyone else shut the fuck up. But then I'd fail.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please, please.
All
I can't tell anybody. They'll think I'm crazy.
Yo, Tanya.
Okay, Max, retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in. And I took a photo.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell Ooh. Everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself.
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with.
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come
Don't
on, put that thing down!
Tell me
I need
to...
a hammer to break
I'm
it open.
Sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they? No way!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Another shitty day.
That did not happen. This cannot be real. I just saw a girl get shot and then saved her. What the fuck is going on? Do not freak out.
Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen. The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone, and please turn off that alarm since that's your job. You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You could always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
Yeah, report him.
I just saw Nathan Prescott waving a gun around. In the girls' room.
Nathan Prescott. You sure?
Yes. He was in the bathroom talking to himself with a gun. I saw everything. He was babbling like crazy.
Okay, slow down. Slow down. So now you saw this without him seeing you.
I was hiding behind a stall. I have the right to be there. It's the girls' room.
I know. I just want to be completely clear what happened. Mr. Prescott happens to be from the town's most distinguished family. And one of Blackwell's most honored students. So it's hard for me to see him brandishing a weapon in the girls' bathroom. So what happened next?
Then he left. I ran out here wondering what to do. Are you gonna bust him?
This is a serious charge. I'll look into the matter personally. Thank you for bringing it to my attention.
That's it? After what I told
you? We'll continue this discussion later, in my office. Please go outside with the rest of your class now, Miss Caulfield.
Of course this academic drone won't do anything, since the Prescott family owns Blackwell now.
Well, what the hell did you think was gonna happen?
Nathan Prescott, please come to the front office. Thank you.
I would do that. Do this.
Rachel Amber. She looks so hopeful and pretty. I wonder what happened to her.
Hi, Miss Grant.
Excuse me, Max. I know everybody loves being asked to sign a petition, but would you do Miss Grant a favor and hear me out?
Yeah, sure.
Sure, I always have time for you. What's the petition?
David Madsen, our chief of security, wants to put surveillance cameras all around the campus. Halls, classrooms, gym, dorm rooms, etc. Blackwell Academy should be a high school, not a high security penitentiary.
David Madsen doesn't need another excuse to harass students here.
Max, this isn't about personalities. This is about protecting civil rights and our school's legacy of freedom. Blackwell Academy has a noble heritage, from the Native Americans who founded this land to the pioneers who shared it in peace, not fear and violence.
You know a lot about Blackwell for being the science teacher.
A lot of unique facts about this you might really enjoy discovering. Now, before I assign you homework with this lecture, will you please sign the petition to keep our campus from going back to 1984?
Miss Grant, I totally respect your passion and knowledge, but some security cameras make me feel a little safer.
I'm not against security, Max. We should all be concerned when private space becomes public. Your generation has been tricked to think everything should be recorded.
I better read Warren's text before he blows my phone up. Okay, I better get to my...
What's up, Daniel?
Oh, hi, Max. Could I, ask you a question? Would you mind letting me sketch you? I do put my sketches on Facebook, though.
I'd be honored, Daniel. Makes me feel like a muse.
Funny you should say that. I was just thinking about my real muse. Rachel Amber.
So what happened to her? There's gotta be a story.
She just stopped coming to class. Some people said she ran away. Some say she jumped off a cliff. I just hope she's okay.
Okay, why don't you start drawing me? Even though I must be a step down from Rachel.
No way, you're a good substitute, Muse. Oh. That's a good posture. Good. Good.
Best portrait ever.
Logan, bring it, brah. Yeah!
I need to go to my room and return Warren's flash drive.
It's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell. What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your wave hipster bullshit. The Daguerrean processor. Nice. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled.
No.
Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving. Oh, wait. Hold that pose. So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh, yes, Victoria. I'll get your bony ass out of my way. I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel. I just want to get Victoria the hell out of the way. I could crank the sprinkler up and give Victoria and her clones incentive to beat it.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
sure there's something I can tinker with. I'm just gonna stay there.
Do you understand English? Get lost.
There goes Samuel da Vinci to paint the window.
Yeah. Awesome.
Okay, let's see if this works.
No way! No fucking
way! You okay, Victoria?
Oh, Samuel, sorry. Wet paint is not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo!
Hold on. We'll get some towels. We'll be right back.
So move your ass before I drive.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches.
Oh, dude. Awesome. Yeah. Awesome. Dude.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
Hold that pose.
Nah, I was kidding.
I am sorry. That's an awesome cashmere coat.
It was. But there'll be another.
Well, you always seem to know how to pick the right outfits.
I do have some talent. Mr. Jefferson told me.
I've seen your pictures. You have a great eye. Richard Avedon-esque.
He's one of my heroes. Thanks, Max. I hope those sluts get me a towel before they hang a sign on me. You deserve a better shot. Sorry about blocking you and the go fuck your selfie.
That was mean, but pretty funny.
One of those days, you know?
I know exactly what you mean, Victoria. I'll see you later.
Au revoir.
Victoria probably played.
Victoria is going to be pissed we took so long.
We'll bang for Jesus.
How sad. I didn't write anything. I have nothing to say. Home sweet home. My favorite cocoon. You are thirsty. I'm the worst baby mama. Drink up. Philip Lorca de Corsia, my man. I don't think I could take my camera to those places. Look at that shot. I love Julia Cameron's Victorian vibe. Talk about analog cameras. Ah, Dolly, what a fantastic eye. He could truly freeze time. Daniel has so much talent. I hope nobody hates on it just because it's me. I am so addicted to this site. Look at these vintage beauties. Warren makes me laugh. It's nice to feel like I already made a real friend here. I need to grab the flash drive on my desk before I see Warren.
I didn't say it. Is it there? The fuck?
Hard to believe I'm 18 now. I'm lucky my parents enabled my photo habit into adulthood. Max and Chloe, best friends forever. Who even says that anymore? I'm going to have to call Chloe eventually and find out what she'll say. The longer I wait, the worse it'll be. Idiot. One day I'll organize my film collection. One day I'll get an actual There's my poor laptop begging me to check. Looks like Dana left me a little post-it note. Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room.
You can't get out now, Dana. So tell me the truth or rot in there.
Welcome to the real drama queens of Blackwell.
That's
stupid. Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
You are ridiculous.
What did she do?
What didn't she do? Dana's been sexting with my boyfriend.
Ouch. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
Duh.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do. Just because I don't talk a lot doesn't mean I don't care. So, how did you find out about them?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything. But I bet Victoria did. I know the proof is in her room.
Answer, you wuss.
Yeah, I have to find Victoria's room. That's Kate's. It's mine. Victoria's.
Is she going to get a 3D printer for her dorm room? Maybe I will join her posse. I'll give Victoria props for not posting my photo. And for this nice shot. Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here. This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent. Juliet, read this.
Of course. I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Almost done. Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren.
Max, that's mine. Thank you. You're not helpful. You're just nosy. I think you better go.
Nice, Max. You hurt her feelings by being so damn nosy again. But I could rewind and make it up to her. Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Dana, I'm not trying to be nosy, but I heard a rumor about you.
What? Who told you I was pregnant?
Nobody important. They just acted like it was bullshit. I just wanted you to know.
It's like a goddamn reality show around here. Can you keep a secret, Max?
Of course.
I was pregnant. Was.
Oh. What about the other?
Deadbeat Dad? You can catch him on the 40-yard line this Friday. And it's not Zachary.
Who then? And you don't have to tell me. In fact, you better not.
I like your spirit, Max. Anyway, you better get that flash drive so Warren has an excuse to bug you.
Must protect my precious, so Max never has to chase it down again.
Of course a popular cheerleader like Dana would have a million friends. So fascinating to get a peek into Dana's social media world. And yes, Max, so terribly
wrong. I completely forgot
that
I was streaming. To the point where I haven't spoken in, like, ages.
This shit.
Ooh.
That hurt.
Damn, I better rewind.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Ooh, he's in.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
So
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate. I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now Officer David Dickhead is after me.
Actually gonna try to play through every single one of them at the same time.
I'm glad I stepped in that time.
Well, that's
can't
right.
Stand to see people being bullied.
I just noticed.
I don't get it. How could Zach and Victoria do that?
Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zach yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He usually does. Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
Max, get your ass over here.
Shut up, Warren.
That dog looks peaceful asleep, but if I get too close, Cujo.
Come on over here, please.
Shut up, Warren.
Look at Warren and his Wayback Machine. He's a brave man.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
You can draw? I thought you were blind to science, not art.
Art is science. Music is math, etc., etc. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Hard thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Seen it.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white. Plus, babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I don't want to speak about it. This is kind of a crazy day for me. I mean, I literally think I'm going crazy.
I may be a pest, but I'm a good listener.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal? Now! Answer me, bitch!
What are you talking about?
I know you're new here, but don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new. I've lived here for years.
Then you should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me. Worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Bruh.
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore
right
in the bathroom!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up. And dangerous. This day
it doesn't
never
say
ends.
That you're watching.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
I have no idea. I know he's a Prescott.
And an asshole. Your friend really stood up for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Of course, it's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Mm-hmm.
Broken. Man, are you cereal?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage. And he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max. Come on in. Don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
Bruh. I can hear that.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-fuhrer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Get high.
Hey, give me that. Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
Yeah.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
So, Rachel took my place. I'm glad she was there for you.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
I see why. I bet your mom was not too happy.
She was happy enough to marry a Nazi. Reason number 356 to escape.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
What about her parents? Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing.
I assume you know more than that.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
It won't play without any power.
Well, then give it power. How the fuck do I turn it on? Found it. You can stop looking now. Thank you.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
All right. Peace, bitch.
Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days. I haven't seen this place in 5 years. I should be able to. Find the tools I need here. Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For reals? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this?
Probably not. And close that. Yeah, I was gonna say, if I remember.
Ooh, precision screwdrivers. Except, I can't reach them. That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. Man, I should have done that before they fell. Mad skills, Max.
Let's fix this camera. Upstairs.
She looks super happy. She looks super sad. She looks super stoned.
Rodia?
So?
I can't fix this thing.
Rip.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah. I just took them today.
Let me see.
Just don't let her see the butterfly one.
I've seen this before.
Oh, really? She's this is the
no way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there, hiding in the corner.
Damn, you're a ninja.
A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
Nope.
Not at all. Your hair and clothes are so different.
I hope so. I'm sure this is all so weird to you after coming back.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Just a bit, not really. They're the same thing.
Just a bit.
There's no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
Like who?
Like who?
Like anybody. Stop stalling, sister.
The principal. But he didn't seem to believe me.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash from Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
I didn't mention you at all. Swear.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max.
Oh my God. If they're gonna give me an option to say yes or no, then when I choose no, I expect the answer to be no. Not, huh?
I know it was your birthday last month.
Fuck, man.
This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool.
Oh my God,
I'm definitely
going to be needing that picture
so
back,
sweet.
That's for sure.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance. Shake that phony white ass. Or Bruh. Take my picture with your new camera.
Bruh, again.
This day couldn't get any stranger.
God, am I seriously taking a photo? I'm blazing and everything.
This song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl.
Don't even attempt to dance.
Yes, break it down, Max.
Good God.
Yo, turn it off. Turn it off.
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on.
Oh my God, Max is
asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, shit.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe.
I'm coming.
Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Let me in now. Please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
Oh, no.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe,
I need
open
to
this
find
door.
Another way in. Hide under
I'm
the
not
bed.
A kid anymore. I can't hide under the bed. Where else?
One,
I'll hide here.
Two, three.
Shit.
What's going on in here? Why is she here?
None of your business.
I don't like strangers here.
Stop freaking. She's not a stranger. This is my friend.
Great. Another one of your friends.
My hiding spot wasn't that good.
One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh, God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been token up again in here?
Oh, yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth. That's an order.
It's not my pot. It's from Max.
Bitch.
Is this true?
Bitch. You won't blame me. You won't blame me. Just because I'm your best friend, your business has to be my business. Well, you know what?
Yeah. My pot.
So you're bringing drugs into my home. How about if I call the police?
How about
that's
I whoop
screw
your...
up your spotless Blackwell record?
And I whoop your
you
ass.
Do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Missy, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble. Like this afternoon. You don't have anything smart to say now.
Get the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't have any friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
Oh, the double burn.
Chloe. And Max, if I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win.
Anyway, let's peek out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this kickhole.
Nothing's funnier than when seeing people flip each other off.
Man, that did not go well for me.
I don't give a shit. I want to keep my Black Widow
scholarship. I shouldn't lie for anybody, even Chloe. I have to think about my own future.
Max, open the window and we can blow this popsicle stand.
Oh, really? We're gonna jump out the window? Sweet. Yee, bang. Let's go out backwards. Never mind, I've been recording this episode for an hour. I might not try to do all two or three, all three episodes in one go. Because that's like 3 hours of streaming in one go, and my stream will automatically end. 7 what? For what?
7 hours of streaming.
Episode 1, 2, and 3. Life is Strange. This is pretty much the end of the episode.
Isn't this
it's only
awesome,
1 hour.
Sauce? Totally reminds me of when we were kids.
It's about 1 to 2 hours.
Come
every
on, slowpoke! Hold on.
I haven't been here in forever. So why do I feel like I was just here?
Because this is where you had the tornado dream.
This is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today.
Oh, she's gonna have that damn nightmare again. She's stupid. Warren. God, Jesus. I need to just scroll up a little. God. You legend. You legend.
Birds are so lucky.
The fuck does... The fuck... Hang on. Fuck off, Dad. Warren. What the fuck does Keck mean?
They can always escape.
Map. And map. And the campfire. I'm the graffiti. I'm the wall. Graffiti. Harambe.
Chloe's step douche better not cause me trouble.
Oh no, I'm the one causing the trouble. Not step douche.
Sure you don't want to be alone?
Have a seat, Pete.
You're in a good mood.
You're in a good mood?
Seeing my step dork get played makes me happy.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is indeed a step douche.
I'm sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
You have to live with him. Has he always been this way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
He freaked out on poor Kate Marsh today.
I know her. He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Bruh. Did you take a peek?
I wish. You know I would have read them.
I'd love to. They must be important, or he wouldn't hide them deep in his garage bunker.
He kind of creeps me out. I bet the truth is out there in his files.
Most likely, but it's good you didn't find his files. He would go ballistic. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
I knew you didn't know. Chloe, your house is under surveillance.
What are you talking about?
There are cameras all over the house. I saw it on a monitor in the garage.
I knew it. He's so hella fucking paranoid. I'll keep this a secret for now.
Sometimes ignorance is bliss.
No wonder I'm so miserable. Everybody in this town knows everybody's secrets.
Even yours?
Not anymore.
So what do you have on Nathan?
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit cut with laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
What?
What?
I met him in some shithole bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe. Now.
I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Actually, yes. I owe big time. And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
Over here. There we go.
Wow.
How much do you owe?
$3,000 plus interest. And before I could get a chunk of that from Nathan, he dosed my drink with some shit.
God, Chloe.
He wants the
internet password. I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor. I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a lamp. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
That's uncontrollable.
Chloe, that is so fucked up. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So I met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
He's still dangerous, Chloe. Not just to you.
Oh, good thing you notified the principal. I feel safer already.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like
destiny.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max.
She dead.
This shit pit has taken away everyone I've ever loved. I'd like to drop a bomb on Arcadia Bay and turn it to fucking glass.
Straight for the town. Chloe, you're here. I'm back. Oh my lord, this is real. It's real. Oh man, this sucks.
Max, what's going on? You totally blacked out.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Oregon gets about 5 tornadoes every 20 years. You just zoned.
No, I saw it. I could actually feel the electricity in the air.
Come on, take a breath, okay?
Chloe, I'm not crazy. But there's something else I have to tell you. Something hardcore.
Talk to me, Max. I had this same vision earlier in class. When I came out of it, I discovered I could reverse time. Like I said, not crazy.
But high, right?
Listen to me. How do you think I saved you in the bathroom?
By reversing time? Yeah, sure.
I saw you get shot, Chloe. Saw you actually die. I was able to go back and hit the fire alarm.
Okay, I see you're a geek now with a great imagination, but this isn't anime or a video game. People don't have those powers, Max.
I don't know what I have, but I have it. And I'm scared shitless.
You need to get high. It's been a hell insane fucking day. What the hell is this?
Snowflakes?
It's like 80 degrees. How?
Climate change. Or a storm is coming.
Max, start from the beginning. Tell me everything.
Well, that was episode one. I made the clan. Alright, you reported. Okay, you reported Nathan. You comforted Victor. You intervened to help out Kate. You took the blame. Yeah, a lot of people got the hiding spot. I did the hiding spot last time I played, and so yeah. You let Daniel draw, you didn't sign Miss Grant's petition, you helped Alyssa, you erased the insults on Kate's slate, you watered your plant, you didn't touch Dan's pregnancy test, you didn't read David's files, yeah, that was, I didn't even know, you didn't leave any evidence, made sure I didn't, you didn't break close, no, like, you could do that? You let the bird die. What bird? Ah! You didn't write on a dirty VR. RV. Oh, what? It wouldn't let me. You didn't touch Victoria's photos. Oh, she dies. So yeah, that was episode 1. Episode 2 will be out tomorrow. I'll see you Red Faction members in the afterlife.